So let's turn our attention now to the idea of comparing two different population parameters. So far, we've been taking one population parameter and comparing it with what we believe the value to be and make a determination whether that's reasonable or not based on the sample data. Now I want to compare two different population parameters, which really means we're comparing two different groups. So like usual, let's take a look at the learning objectives, make sure that we're heading in the right direction, that we get what we need to get out of these videos. First of all, we want to understand the difference between independent and dependent data. This is extremely important. Now that you're working with two groups of data, one of the very first things that you're going to have to do is make a determination as to whether they're independent or dependent, because that will completely dictate the path that you're going to take. And of course, we'll talk about the difference between these when we're making or assigning those terms to two different data sets. We want to construct, interpret, obviously test a hypothesis comparing these two population parameters. And the parameters that we'll be looking at will be mu, theta, and pi. So two groups of mu, two groups of theta, two groups of pi. That's what we'll be looking at. And I'm actually going to introduce a new one. I may as well tell you right now, it's lambda, which is an odds ratio. We'll come to that. We want to identify the appropriate parameters to compare based on the data, just like we've done before. That's really making reference to should you use mu or theta. And we want to comprehend the difference between practical, sometimes referred to as clinical, depending on what area that you're working in, and statistical significance. This is really an extremely important concept. Okay, let's start off with the idea of dependent versus independent data. Before we can look at techniques used for the comparison of two samples, we must first discuss the meaning of independent. I didn't leave myself much room here, and dependent samples. Now, in general, if the same source, this is important, if the same source is used to obtain two different samples, then the data is thought of as being dependent. In other words, they're related to each other because they came from the same source. Now, the classic dependent data example is that of a test retest situation, or very commonly referred to as a before and after situation. So in other words, you test a group of people and then you have some type of intervention, and then after the intervention you retest to see if the intervention had a positive or negative effect, hence the before and after idea. Now, when we're talking about dependent data, the basic idea is that there's some type of natural pairing, a natural pairing of the data, and that's because it's two data points or data values that came again from the same source. If they came from the same source, then there's a natural pairing. If two different sources are used, then the data is typically thought of as being independent. In other words, they're not related. So let's take a quick example, a look at a couple of different examples here for dependent data. So suppose you want to do a price comparison test, and you're looking at the Vons versus the Albertsons grocery stores. And you may go get a Campbell's chicken noodle soup, CNS, that's my shortcut today for chicken noodle soup. Well, it's Campbell's chicken noodle soup, so maybe at Vons, maybe it's 89 cents, and Albertsons is maybe 83 cents today. It's the same item because it's the same chicken noodle soup. If they're, I don't know, if they're 12-ounce cans, then it's both the exact same thing. It's not physically the same can. It's not like you go to Vons, record it, and then expect to physically find that exact same can at Albertsons. That doesn't make any sense, but it's the same item. The same manufacturer, the same size, the same everything. It's just being sold at two different stores. And then maybe we're going to look at Bright Dairy milk, a gallon of milk. Oops, I need an L there. Milk. Maybe it's $2.89 at Vons and $2.99 at Albertsons and so forth. Yada, yada, yada. All these different items. Now again, it's dependent because it comes from the same source, or the same item at two different stores. So if I simply subtract these two, I could quickly tell whether this is a positive or a negative, depends on which way I subtract them. In general, which one is more expensive? So if I take Vons subtracts Albertsons, I'll get a positive value. Tell me that first one, Vons, is more expensive. And here, Vons minus Albertsons will give me a negative value. Tell me that Albertsons is more expensive. So this is definitely a dependent data situation because, again, we're taking measurements from the same source, just two different locations. Now here, this is an example like a test retest. So suppose we give an exam. And then they say student number one had a 67 on the exam, student number two had a 75, and student number three had a 91. And let's say there is a bunch of low scores, so we did another day of worksheets or discussion, something on the topic, and then had the second exam as a different exam, but over the same information. And then maybe student number one on the second exam had a 72, this student had an 84, maybe this student had an 89. Well, again, it's pairing because it's the same student. It is physically the same student, the first exam versus the second. And by subtracting these, if I take the second exam, subtract from it the first, what I would expect is a bunch of positive numbers. That would tell me that in general, the intervention, the extra training, the extra whatever, worked. So again, dependent because it's the same source. Student 1, student 2, student 3, these measurements were taken from the same source. Now what about independent data? Well, let's suppose we had a chapter exam, say chapter 13 or something. And what I did is I took a look at my day class and my night class. So maybe I had student number one, number two, number three, and so forth. And the day class was maybe a 97, an 82, an 88, whatever. And then the night class was maybe a 91, a 90, an 89, and so forth. See here, subtract these two would make absolutely no sense whatsoever because student number one from the day class, maybe it's Sally or something, is not student number one from the day class. Maybe that's Joe or something. I don't know. The point is, this is different people. So how would I select two people to subtract their scores to see how the class did better? No, they're completely independent. Subtracting here makes absolutely no sense whatsoever. Why is it that these numbers are written in this order? It could have been, well, it's not high to low. It is down here, but not up here. It could have been alphabetical by last name. See, there's no natural pairing. It does not make any sense to think about subtracting these or comparing person by person. It makes more sense to compare as a group to this group as a whole. So this is independent data. There's two different sources. It may feel like the same source because they're both chapter 13, but chapter 13 isn't being measured. It's the student being measured. This is the source. And like I said, student one here is not the same as student one down here. So there's two different sources. So in general, that's the basic idea behind independent and dependent data. And from here on out, whenever we have two groups or more than two groups of data that we want to make comparisons, the very first thing that you're going to have to do, well, it may not be the first thing, but you're going to have to determine whether it's independent or dependent. You may want to at first determine the parameter that you're interested in, then go to independence versus dependence. Although you could easily switch that order, it doesn't really make that much difference. But clearly, you're going to have to make a determination whether it's independent or dependent because that will completely dictate how you're going to actually make the comparison.